The morcellator is increasing the occurrence of uterine cancer, while the FDA sits silent. See the story at drugsafetynews.com.
The latest is Rachel Maddow. I mean, my God, all of a sudden, Rachel has this love affair with Hillary and is ignoring the issues that progressives, who put her there, by the way, are interested in talking about.
Well, you know what's very interesting is that very point you just brought up there. It's not just the establishment within the Democratic Party. It's the establishment press. And that's not just the corporate media. We have all kinds of independent, allegedly independent media outlets out there right now who have become just shills for Hillary Clinton because either they worked, you know, for a campaign of hers, or they worked for her Senate staff, or they worked for her husband. These are establishment groups that are out there, you know, attacking Bernie Sanders, spouting off this pro-Hillary stuff. But the average people, the readers who go to their websites, don't understand that they are from the Clinton administration.
Yeah,
they are Washington.
They are. That is misunderstood. Some of these independents, you say, oh, well, surely, you know, this organization that I'm reading, and they're good on most of our issues. They don't understand how connected and how longstanding those Hillary connections have been. Which brings me to this next issue. You know, this position that Hillary's taken, that she's sick of the left, that she's tired of the left, that she wants to get in the face of people who say that they're on the left and point her finger and raise hell with them when they ask a tough question. What has happened here? I mean, how are they so out of touch that they don't understand? The left is what put Obama in power. Even though he absolutely has ignored the same people that put him in power, are they going to do it again?
They absolutely are. And Hillary is sick of the Democratic Party. But so is Bill Clinton. Remember a couple years ago when he was talking with his Wall Street buddies, and he said, look, we could hand him Lloyd Blankfein's head on a platter and it still wouldn't be enough for them. They're sick of the progressive base of the Democratic Party. And they're not making that, you know, hidden anymore. They're just coming right out and doing it because Hillary knows, look, I've kind of got this in the bag, maybe. So I'm just going to say and do whatever the hell I want. Now, when she got in that woman's face and said, I'm sick of the Bernie Sanders campaign spreading these lies, that was a lie. We know for a fact that out of every presidential candidate running that has run this entire season, Hillary Clinton has received the third most amount of money in direct contributions from oil and gas industries. Now, when you factor in how much those groups have bundled for her and how much that the oil and gas sponsored super PACs have funneled into her campaign, Hillary Clinton has received more money than any other person running for president from the oil and gas industry. First time in history that person is a Democrat.
Farron, the story is bigger than Hillary, you know, taking her finger and poking it in the face of a Greenpeace reporter. The story is that the Democratic leadership is, who, by the way, is Debbie Wasserman Schultz, if you can imagine. That is what we call Democratic leadership. That they're no longer recognizable as what we used to term Democrats. Bill Clinton came in office and he worked so desperately to move that party to the middle because, as he kept saying, well, gee whiz, we can't be elected if we don't. Well, that was a lie. You know, and so in the process of that lie, he gives us NAFTA. He gives the corporate media the chance to come in and buy all the media. That was his. That was his legislation that did that. He puts us in a posture to where Wall Street now is our best friend. You know, Wall Street is our voice, and nothing has changed since then. Obama carried that out, and now Hillary says that she's simply going to continue the Obama politics. That's her mantra. We're not going to change anything. We're going to do exactly what Obama did. And it's almost as if they don't understand that doesn't work anymore. It's ancient news. It's like a bunch of old people who never have figured out that things are different out there right now.
Well, you know, the Clintons back when they were in Arkansas probably did understand, you know, what it was like to be a working class American voter. But then once they got to the White House, and especially after they left the White House, they immediately joined the 1% or 0.001% based on their total net worth. They lost touch. And they didn't bother to listen to what the public was saying, what the party base was saying. And so they just went along living in their little Washington billionaire or millionaire bubble, not caring, because they can do whatever they want and still hold positions of power within the Democratic Party, because that's the way the party is structured. That's why we have super
delegates. Well, you know, we're kidding ourselves. Some of these people who call themselves Democrats are kidding themselves. They it's almost like they don't even understand what a Democrat used to look like. And so they think they're Democrats. And, you know, I guess that's what the Democratic Party has become. I made that decision, 15 years ago? I've been an independent sort of that long because they started scaring the hell out of me.